dealing with angles. Like the previous chapter, we talked about the origin of angles. I explained that we get angle at the area where two lines meet. We get angle. Any area that two lines meet, an angle will be formed. So, angle, like I said earlier, that angle is a point, is the area where two lines meet. So, like you can see, we represent angle with this sign, the arc sign. So, I went further to explain the types of angle we have, which are acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle, straight line angle. Straight line angle. So, the acute angle are angles that are less than 90 degrees. The acute angle are less than 90 degrees. The obtuse angle are greater than 90 degrees. Then, the right angle are angles that are equal to 90 degrees. While the straight line angle are angles that are equal to 180 degrees. So, like we can say example of acute angle, we can say angles that are like 1 degree to 89 degrees. These are acute angles, like 45 degrees, 30 degrees, 70 degrees, 60 degrees, 55 degrees. All these angles are example of acute angle because they are less than 90. The right angle are angles that are equal to 90 degrees. Then we have the straight line angle. They are also angles that are equal to 90 degrees. They are not greater than the straight line angle, are angles that are equal to 180 degrees. It's not greater than 180 degrees and it's not less than 180 degrees. Then the right angle also is 90 degrees. So I explain further by categorizing angle under supplement and complement. The supplement angle are angles. The supplement angle are angles that combine to form 180 degrees. Supplement angle combined to form 180 degrees. Example of a supplement angle. So they combine to form 180 degrees. That is the supplement angle. Example of a supplement angle is this. This is supplement angles. Let's say this 80, then this 100. So these are to 180 degree, and angle 80 is also supplement angle to 180 degree. So these two are supplement angle. Then we have the complement angle. Complement So, like I said, the supplement angle combine are angles that combine to form 180 degree. There can be two angles, there can be more than two angles, but as far as they are combination of angles that form 180 degree, they are supplement angle. Then we example of a supplement angle is 100 degree and 80 degree. So these two angles combine to form the two angles combine to form 180 degree. To form the right angle, that is angle 90 degree. We can say this is 45 degree and this is 45 degree. So these two angles are complement. Angle. These are
sine
complement
is for angle.
So corresponding angle are equal. That is our sixth theorem. So therefore, angle A is equal to 70 degree, which is equal to angle X, which is equal to 70 degree. So angle X is 70 degree. So now have this angle to be 70 degree. So angle P is alternate angle to angle E. Let me name it angle E. So which is 120 degree. So to find angle P will be equal to angle E. Which is alternate angles. They are alternate angles. So where P, where E, angle E, this angle E is 120 degree. So is alternate to angle P. So where E is equal to 120 degree is equal to angle P. So angle E. Therefore, angle P is equal to 120 degree. That is alternate angle. Alternate angle are equal. That is still part of our sixth theorem. So therefore, angle P is now will be 120 degree. So angle F, so we will draw our imaginary line here. Then name here to be angle X. Then name here to be angle F. But originally, we are supposed to find angle B, angle A, and angle C. So originally, we have to find angle C. So, we will first of all look for angle A. This angle A. So angle A will give us angle A plus this angle plus 60 equal to 180 degree. That is our first theorem that says that our third theorem that says that angle on a straight line is equal to 180 degree. So A will now be 180 minus 60. So angle A here will now be 120 degree. So already we'll get this to be 120 degree. So since D This is 120 degrees. We've gotten it. We will now look for angle B. Angle B will be B plus 48 degrees equal to 180 degrees. So angle on a straight line. That is the third theorem. So B will now be 48 degrees. I take it again. Equal to 180 degrees. So angles on a straight line. That is our third theorem. So B will now be equal to 180 degrees minus 48 degrees. So B will now be, the B will now be 48, that is B plus 48 equal to 180 degrees. That is angle on a straight line. Then B will be 180 minus 48. So B will now be 132. So already B is now 132 degrees. So the next is for us to find C. For us to find angle C, we've draw an imaginary line. So this line is now parallel to each other. So the line is now intersecting. There are two opposite lines that are intersecting. So here we'll find that F will find F for us to get C. First of all, find F. F will be equal to 60 degrees. That is, F is alternate to this angle, 60 degrees. So F will be 60 degrees. So X is alternate to this angle. So X will be 48 degrees. So for us to get 60, for us to get angle C, we'll consider this as angle on a straight line. So I'll name this angle I. So I will now be equal to 180 minus 48. That is angle on a straight line. So I will be 132. So here will be 132 degrees. So that is angle on a straight line. So for us to find angle, let's assume this angle. We minus this from 180 degrees. That is angle on a straight line. That is 180 degrees minus 60 degrees. So which will give us, that is 180 minus 60 degrees, which will give us 120 degrees. So this angle now will be 120 degrees. So since we've gotten this angle and this angle, we will now calculate C, because from year to year gives us angle C. To find angle C will now be 132 degrees plus